Have you ever wondered how your brain can adapt and change throughout your life? What if I told you that the key to unlocking your brain's full potential lies in understanding neuroplasticity? In today's video, we'll explore how you can rewire your brain, enhancing your mental resilience and overall well-being. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I help strengthen your mind and fortify your brain to build resilience. When you grasp how neuroplasticity works, you'll realize that change isn't just possible, it's within your control. And today is a deep dive on neuroplasticity. What is neuroplasticity? Neuroplasticity is your brain's ability to reorganize itself by forming new neural connections throughout your life. Think of it this way. Imagine you're walking through a forest and you take the same path every day. Over time, that path becomes more defined and easier to follow. Similarly, when you repeat certain thoughts or behaviors, you create well-worn pathways in your brain. The exciting part is you're not stuck with those pathways. Neuroplasticity means that you can always create new paths, and this ability is necessary for learning, personal growth, and building resilience. It's not just about recovering from brain injuries. It's about shaping your mind to adapt and thrive in the face of life's challenges. For decades, scientists believed that the brain structure was fixed after childhood, but functional imaging has advanced, and newer research has shown that our brains continue to change and adapt well into adulthood. This shift from a fixed brain to a plastic brain model has revolutionized our understanding of brain function and mental health. There are two types of neuroplasticity: structural plasticity, and this involves changes to the brain's physical structure, such as the growth of new neurons or the formation of new synapses. And then there's functional plasticity, and this refers to the brain's ability to move functions from a damaged area to other undamaged areas. Neuroplasticity gives you the power to influence your brain structure and function through your experiences and behaviors. Neuroplasticity does work both ways. So negative thinking and behaviors also reinforce certain pathways in the brain. However, once you start replacing those negative habits with positive ones, the new pathways begin to take over, helping you become more mentally strong and adaptable. To understand how neuroplasticity works, let's look at the basics of brain structure. Your brain consists of billions of neurons, which are the cells responsible for processing and transmitting information. These neurons, or nerve cells, communicate with each other through connections called synapses. When you learn something new or have a novel experience, your neurons form new connections or strengthen existing ones. And this process is called synaptic plasticity. The more you repeat an action or thought, the stronger the neural pathways become. It's like creating a well-worn path in your brain. Several key brain regions are involved in neuroplasticity. The hippocampus, which is important for memory formation and spatial orientation, which is the ability for you to be able to tell how your body's positioned in space. Then there's the amygdala, which is involved in emotional processing and fear responses. And then the prefrontal cortex, which is responsible for higher order thinking and decision making. And these areas work together to process new information, form new memories, and adapt to changing environments. So that's how neuroplasticity works. Here's why it's important for building mental strength and resilience. It impacts four main areas of functioning. First, adaptability. Neuroplasticity allows your brain to adapt to new situations and challenges, and this flexibility is the basis for being able to navigate the ups and downs and develop resilience. Second is learning and memory. When you have new experiences and form new neural connections, you're able to learn new skills and retain information. Being able to learn boosts your confidence and problem-solving abilities, so you can, in fact, teach an old dog new tricks. The third impact of neuroplasticity is overcoming negative patterns. Neuroplasticity empowers you to change negative thought patterns and behaviors. You can consciously and intentionally create new neural pathways and up-level poor coping skills and reshape how you respond to stress and adversity. And the fourth impact is recovery and healing. Neuroplasticity plays a vital role in recovery from brain injuries and managing mental health conditions. It offers hope for healing and improving even in challenging circumstances. Several factors can impact your brain's plasticity. There's your age. Even though neuroplasticity occurs throughout life, it tends to be more pronounced in younger brains. That said, even older adults can benefit from activities that promote plasticity. A rich, stimulating environment promotes neuroplasticity. This includes engaging in new experiences, learning new skills, and exposing yourself to diverse sensory inputs. The interplay between neuroplasticity and sensory input is one of the reasons hearing loss, vision loss, and social isolation are so harmful to your mental functions. And then there's lifestyle factors. Sleep, nutrition, and exercise all play critical roles in supporting neuroplasticity. Quality sleep helps consolidate memories. A balanced diet with minimal processed foods provides nutrients for brain health. And regular exercise increases blood flow to the brain and promotes the growth of new neurons. Okay, so that's a lot on neuroplasticity. Now let's look at some practical strategies to harness the power of neuroplasticity and build mental strength. I'm going to give you three strategies. One is learning new skills. Challenging your brain with new activities stimulates the formation of new neural connections. And this could be learning something like a musical instrument, picking up a new language, or trying a new hobby. The second strategy is metacognition and mindfulness. Metacognition is thinking about thinking. It's a powerful tool for enhancing neuroplasticity and building mental strength. It involves becoming aware of your thought processes and learning to regulate them effectively. Here's how you can practice metacognition. One is self-reflection. Regularly take time to examine your thoughts and reactions. Ask yourself, why did I respond that way? Or what assumptions am I making? Next is thought journaling. Write down your thoughts and analyze them objectively. Look for patterns or cognitive distortions. Then engage in mindful meditation. This practice helps you observe your thoughts without judgment, increasing your metacognitive awareness. By developing metacognitive skills, you can identify and challenge unhelpful thought patterns, improve your decision-making process, enhance your emotion regulation, and boost your learning and problem-solving abilities. Combining metacognition with mindfulness creates an effective synergy for rewiring your brain and building resilience. Now, if this sounds like it's a lot to do on your own, I have something that can help you with all of these activities. It's my Essential Tools card deck. They are cards that you can carry with you and use on the go. Cards 8 through 17 give you the common cognitive distortions. These can help you recognize unhelpful thought patterns. Cards 18 to 24 help you accurately label your emotions. And cards 39 to 46 give you 8 grounding exercises that you can use for mindful activities. Sometimes it's hard to think of these exercises on your own, especially if you're stressed or mentally occupied. There's 52 cards with helpful tools, and you can get them at mentalwellnessstore.com or attached to this video. So what I just talked about was the second strategy to build mental strength using metacognition and mindfulness. The first one was learning a new skill. The third strategy is to engage in activities that challenge your brain, such as puzzles, strategy games, or brain training apps. Even though the clinical effectiveness of brain training games is debated, any activity that engages your mind can contribute to cognitive flexibility. In my last video on how thoughts strengthen your mind, I talked about the stress response and the cascade of brain chemicals that get activated when you feel threatened or stressed. You can use some of these techniques that I just discussed to turn down the dial on this response to improve your emotional resilience. So the message here is, understanding neuroplasticity empowers you to take an active role in shaping your brain and, by extension, your mental strength and resilience. Every thought, action, and experience has the potential to rewire your brain. By engaging in activities that promote neuroplasticity, like practicing metacognition and cultivating a growth mindset, you can build a more resilient, adaptable brain. And speaking of growth mindset, another tool I have for you is my Growth Mindset 2025 calendar. The quote on the front is, "Growth is the only evidence of life," by John Henry Newman. I love that statement. It's more than a calendar, though. It's 52 weeks of exercises or reminders related to that month's theme. For example, the theme for June is deeper connections. The quote for that month is, "A real friend is one who walks in when the rest of the world walks out," by Walter Winchell. The tip for week 26 is to practice active listening in your conversations this week. This is where you are giving the person your full attention, looking at them while they speak, and following up with questions. So often we talk while distracted, maybe while scrolling on social media, and that interaction lacks the real connection that it would if we were both fully locked into each other. In fact, I think we're so used to engaging in distracted interactions that the person talking may not even notice that you're not looking at them because they're also scrolling on their phone while they're talking to you. So there's lots of these weekly tips or exercises along with the affirming quotes for you to reflect on for each month. The quality of the paper is cardstock, so it will last a while and can be a keepsake that you can use in years to come. It comes with these fun reminder stickers and makes a great gift. So here's my final thought. You've seen today how your brain is not fixed. It's a dynamic organ capable of remarkable change. By harnessing the power of neuroplasticity, you can strengthen your mind, fortify your brain, and build the resilience that you need to thrive. In future videos, we'll go deeper into specific strategies for promoting neuroplasticity and building mental strength. We'll explore topics like the role of sleep in brain health, nutrition for cognitive function, and advanced mindfulness techniques. Stay tuned, and remember, every step you take towards understanding and nurturing your brain is a step toward a more resilient, empowered you. Thank you for watching today, and I'll see you in the next video.